So I've been having like this little lightweight craving for some chutney ever since I went and ate at that Indian restaurant. So I am going to put together my version of mango onion chutney today. So that's what I'm about to do. So the first thing I'm going to do in a heavy bottom pan is add some ghee. Okay, you guys, this recipe is so simple and yummy. First things first is I like to cook my spices. Then you add your aromatics, which are the ginger, the garlic, the onion. Let that all cook down. Get you some really juicy mangoes. It's the end of mango season here, so I had some really good ones for this recipe. Then you want to add in your cinnamon and the rest of your spices. And I found some really great mountain honey as well. And I add raisins. You know, like that potato salad thing, I do the raisin thing in my chutney. So good. It's delicious. And while my chutney was cooking, I decided to go ahead and tackle the plants. They had come in. They were all still in their boxes for almost a week. And then I had to wait for some dirt. And the dirt finally came in. Actually, it was peat moss. Waited for the peat moss to come in. And now it's time to put them in their new apartment. I'm excited. I love chutney. So I braided my hair. I cut it first. Then I braided it up again. So the goal is to make it like a wavy kind of bob. So we shall see. So now I'm going to go ahead and try to dip it without burning myself. So I did this thing, I cut my hair, I dipped it, so now we're going to see what it turns out looking like. It's already lighter, so that is already a win for me because it was just too heavy. Make it a little shorter. Yeah. So after getting my hair done, of course, hubby and I went to lunch and we went to our favorite place, El Guna. And this time we found a Greek restaurant and it was just so cute in there. It does remind you of the Grecian coast. So we had some really great wine and I started my meal off with a lentil soup that was so creamy and delicious. We had the Greek salad, which was very fresh and crisp. Wonderful rolls, very light and airy, and they paired very well with the tahini. And then he had rice in a lamb tagine, which is lamb cooked in a pot. And I had the lamb chops, which were grilled. And full disclosure, they were over for me, but still very tasty. And I highly recommend this place. So if you're in El Guna, check out the Greek restaurant right next to the fish restaurant.
Bagel sandwich, and I can't find any bagels here. I've gone to several bakeries, they don't have them, so I'm gonna make my own, and I'm gonna use the everything bagel seasoning on it, but they don't have that here either. So I'm gonna be making that as well as making bagels today.
Okay, you guys, so I put together the ingredients for the everything but bagel seasoning. I'm starting off with some onion flakes. We got toasted sesame seeds and regular sesame seeds. And I have some garlic that I found. It's like granulated garlic because I couldn't find garlic flakes, but it's organic and everything. And I have my salt, my Himalaya sea salt. And then I'm going to be using some black cumin seeds because I couldn't find any poppy seeds. And I like the flavor of these. I'm going to try it with this. And if these are too strong, then I'm going to use
probably gonna put some chia seeds on in place of poppy seeds, because I can't, they don't have those here. So yeah, so this is what we're starting with. This is the mix. And I have found these cute little containers on Amazon Egypt here, and I use them like, you know, for all of my seasonings, all of my spices and seasonings and stuff. It works out really well. So the recipe basically gonna start off with equal parts.
Well, maybe not equal parts. I mean, you guys, you know how it is once you get started putting a recipe together. But, you know, the intention was all equal parts, but really you need to just go by taste and feel and touch. So that's what kind of what I did. Just stir it up, taste it, and whatever works for you, do that.
Looks pretty good. So yesterday I had started making bagels. That was my goal, to make a bagel recipe, but I ended up making the everything bagel seasoning first. I have that, so I'm gonna make me some avocado toast this morning and use it on that. But I didn't get a chance to make the bagels because I didn't have the right kind of flour. So I put an order in this morning for the flour, so hopefully it'll be here shortly and I can get going and make those bagels today.
Okay, so here is where my extraness went a little too extra. So after I got my dough together, I had just finished talking to my granddaughter on the phone, and she had mentioned, you know, Momo, why don't you just make some of those cinnamon raisin bagels? And I was like, oh my gosh, yeah, that sounds good. So that's what I did. I split the dough in half, and the intention was just to do the everything bagel, seasoning bagel, but then I ended up doing a cinnamon raisin crunch bagel as well. So yeah. So that's what I'm doing here. I split the dough, and instead of having four nice, really big size bagels, I ended up having like 16 mini bagels. But you still follow the regular bagel recipe process, which is going to be on the blog. And then here I'm showing the most important part about making bagels, and that is boiling them. And the reason why you do that is so that you can develop that skin on the bagel that creates that chew. You know, that bagels are known for, it's what differentiates the bagel from a regular piece of bread, okay? And I know my bagels look a little bit like donuts, but it's okay. They were still bagel-y. And another important thing to remember to do is to do an egg wash so that all of the ingredients that you put on top are gonna stick, and so that you get a nice color on your bagels when you cook them. And for me, I cook them inside of I have a new oven. It's a little mini combo oven. It does a whole bunch of things. So I was using the convection oven feature, and that's what I did. I used that for this recipe. And here I am making the crunch topping for the bagel, because why not? And that was basically just some flour, some sugar, and some cinnamon and butter. Sprinkle that on top just so that I can have that crunch.
So the cinnamon crunch one's turned out good too. Kind of hot still. I'll be tasting that in a minute. Yes, I'm proud of myself, you guys. Okay, bagels.
Okay, you guys, so now that I got the bagels all taken care of, I decided to go ahead and pop my plants and put them in their new pots, and it was like just so therapeutic to do. And look at them, they turned out beautiful. And I just put them in some of the really great places in the house that I can look at them all the time, and that makes me happy. Yeah, I love me some plants, so hopefully I won't kill them. And you're probably wondering, whatever happened to those bagels? Well, remember I said I was having a craving for them? Well, I ended up making the sandwich that I was craving. So there's a lox sandwich that's really famous in America, and it has tomato, onion, capers, cream cheese on a bagel. And that's what I was recreating here in Egypt. And it was good. It was very good. I'm happy. Thanks for watching.